In this short video, I'm gonna talk about the ketogenic diet for epilepsy. I will discuss the safety and effectiveness of the keto diet for treating epilepsy. I will also explain what is epilepsy, what causes epilepsy, and what are the common treatments for epilepsy. Also, what are the common misconceptions about keto and epilepsy? And I will also give some useful tips to make following a ketogenic diet more sustainable. By the way, if you're new to my channel, I'm a nutritionist and a health coach. The purpose of my YouTube channel is to provide you with the best science-based information that can help you to improve your health. So first, it's important to discuss epilepsy and the use of the ketogenic diet for treating epilepsy, because there are a lot of misconceptions about it. A ketogenic diet was originally invented by doctors and scientists around 100 years ago with a purpose to treat epilepsy. For a while, it was used as the main epilepsy treatment. However, at that time, the ketogenic diet used was quite different and more difficult to stick with. Now, there's a different version of this diet that is way healthier and easier to stick with. I'll discuss it later on in this video. So, what happened? Why keto is no longer used for epilepsy? The main reason is that following a diet is free. It doesn't cost you anything. So, they decided to invent drugs to manage seizures instead, as this is a more profitable treatment for the pharmaceutical companies. Let's look at what are the most common treatments for epilepsy today. Some patients are untreated. Did you know that even today, some parents believe that their child who has epilepsy is possessed? This leads to many parents not seeking medical attention and not providing their children with the care they need. A very important thing to know. Epilepsy is a neurological disorder in which brain activity becomes abnormal, causing seizures or periods of unusual behavior, sensations, and sometimes loss of awareness. It has nothing to do with being possessed. Then, the most common treatment used for epilepsy is medicines called anti-epileptic drugs. That's the number one treatment used today. And of course, taking these medicines has several side effects. Some people report side effects such as weight gain, tiredness, irritability, feeling sedated, anger, suicidal thoughts, and impaired language skills. About 1 in 6 of epileptic patients report adverse drug effects. And then studies suggest that some epilepsy cases are drug resistant, simply meaning that medicines don't work. This happens in about 1 in 3 adults and 1 in 4 children. Then, if medicines don't work, your doctor might suggest you to get a surgery to remove a small part of the brain that's causing the seizures. If seizures originate at the same place, of course. Interesting, removing a part of your brain. Are there any safer treatment options? Or there's another procedure, where they put a small electrical device inside the body that can help to control seizures. However, some people report no benefits. And then the last treatment option, if all of the conventional treatments don't work, they might offer you the ketogenic diet. Sometimes they still won't. Comparing the risk-to-benefit ratio, I'm wondering, why are they not offering keto as the first treatment option for epilepsy? A ketogenic diet has been shown to help control seizures. I will look into the mechanisms of how the ketogenic diet affects epilepsy later on in this video. Let's come back to the common misconceptions about the ketogenic diet and epilepsy, as this might explain why is the ketogenic diet not so popular anymore. Another misconception about epilepsy and the keto diet is that this way of eating is dangerous. You eat high amounts of fat and you need medical supervision. You have to be monitored by your doctor all the time. And they often base this belief on another belief, that fat is bad for us, and that saturated fat causes heart disease. This belief comes from the 1950s, when one scientist was paid to create studies associating fat and saturated fat with heart disease. And even today, people are still scared of fat. Well, I have a whole video about the role of fat in heart disease, where I share several high-quality studies, systematic reviews, and meta-analysis that found no link between eating fat or saturated fat and risk of heart disease. You can watch this video after if you want to learn more. So, is fat really that bad for us? Having enough of fat in our diets is crucial for our health, and especially our brain function. our brains are made up of fat and cholesterol. Around 60% of our brain is made up of fat. It contains about 25% of all of the cholesterol in our bodies. And most of the cholesterol is located in myelin sheaths, which is this insulating layer that forms around nerves. The composition of myelin is approximately 27% cholesterol and 43% phospholipids, both of which are fats. This myelin sheath allows electrical impulses to transmit quickly and efficiently along the nerve cells. Our bodies can make cholesterol from various foods, but having enough of fats in our diets provides useful materials for building cholesterol that our bodies need. If the brain is too low in cholesterol, its membranes, synapses, myelin sheaths, and lipid rafts can't form or function properly. So this just shows how important dietary fat and cholesterol are for our brain function. And then another misconception is that the ketogenic diet for epilepsy is this boring diet where you eat only fat and have to track each bite of food that you take. And this is also not true, as people with epilepsy can use a different version of the ketogenic diet, the one that has healthy animal protein sources, plenty of non-starchy veggies, healthy fat, especially sources rich in MCTs, medium-chain triglycerides, some nuts, seeds, and berries, to make sure they are getting all the nutrients they need. And this can be done by eating keto-approved foods and not tracking every bite of food that you eat, which makes it a lot easier to stick with. What is epilepsy? Epilepsy is a condition where sudden bursts of electrical activity in the brain cause seizures or fits. A seizure happens when many neurons fire at once in uncontrolled bursts. This firing interferes with how the brain normally functions. In normal conditions, there's a balance between excitatory and inhibitory neurotransmitters. Excitatory neurotransmitters, such as glutamate, excite neuron. This means they increase the likelihood that the neuron will fire. And inhibitory neurotransmitters, such as GABA, have inhibitory effects on the neuron. This means they decrease the likelihood that the neuron will fire. During seizures, the excitation and inhibition become unbalanced. This happens when there's either too much of excitation or too little of inhibition. This results in a group of neurons that fire uncontrollably and randomly. What causes epilepsy? According to CDC, epilepsy can be caused by different conditions that affect a person's brain. Common causes include stroke, brain tumor, traumatic brain injury or head injury, and central nervous system infection. However, there are several other factors that can lead to uncontrolled firing of neurons. These include genetic defects in the brain, environmental triggers, imbalances in minerals such as sodium, potassium, calcium, and magnesium, and some other dietary factors. I'll discuss some of these in more detail. There's a food additive, a flavor enhancer called monosodium glutamate, also called MSG or E621, that is a known neurotoxin. It overexcites and kills neurons. Some epilepsy patients report that MSG triggered their seizures. And there are other potential seizure triggers, such as artificial sweeteners, alcohol, lack of sleep, excess stress, and flashing lights. People with epilepsy should aim for an overall healthy lifestyle, where they sleep enough, avoid alcohol, processed food that is full of additives, especially MSG. And there's one very often overlooked trigger of seizures. It's sugar. And when I say sugar, I mean all forms of sugar. Anything containing the obvious sugar, sweet foods, and high carbohydrate foods, such as pasta, rice, potatoes, and bread, that turn into sugar in our bodies. When we eat carbohydrates, they are broken down into sugar called glucose in our bodies. Glucose causes huge destabilizing effects in the brain. I'm gonna cite one study. In humans with epilepsy, and in several rodent epilepsy models, glucose metabolism is impaired. A deficiency in energy is likely to contribute to the generation of seizures, as the stabilization of membrane potentials and regulated neural signaling require high amounts of energy. This basically means neurons struggle to get energy from glucose, and this results in seizures. if nerve cells can't get energy from glucose, it indicates us that an alternative fuel source, such as ketones, should be considered. Diseases where impaired glucose metabolism is involved always show improvements when using ketones instead of glucose. Sugar causes several other harmful effects. As mentioned earlier, there are excitatory neurotransmitters, the main one being glutamate, and there are inhibitory neurotransmitters, such as GABA. Everything to do with overexcitation of neurons is what causes seizures in epileptic patients, and glucose is used to make glutamate in the body. Glutamate is rapidly synthesized from glucose in neural tissues, and studies show type 1 diabetics who have elevated glucose most of the time suffer from several neurological problems. And if we look at the ketogenic diet and how it affects the brain, we can see that it can provide an alternative source of fuel, ketones instead of glucose. And we also know that keto reduces glutamate and promotes an inhibitory neurotransmitter GABA. So instead of having uncontrolled and random neuron firing on glucose as your fuel, you switch to using ketones that promote calm, balanced function of neurons. And if that wasn't enough, the main ketone body, called beta-hydroxybutyrate, has neuroprotective and antioxidant-stimulating properties in the brain. Brain loves ketones, and ketones love the brain. So, is the keto diet a safe and effective treatment for epilepsy? Yes, it's the most effective and the safest treatment for epilepsy. Let's look at the results of a couple of studies looking at the effectiveness of keto for treating epilepsy. The effectiveness of the ketogenic diet is better than most of the new anti-epileptic drugs, and it works for drug-resistant or refractory epilepsy as well. In general, half of all patients treated with the ketogenic diet will have at least a 50% reduction in seizure frequency. One systematic review showed completely stopped seizures in 16% of children, greater than 90% reduction in 32%, and greater than 50% reduction in 56% of children. Also, there has been a recent randomized controlled trial of the ketogenic diet in refractory epilepsy. Children were randomized to receive ketogenic diet either after a 1 month treatment group or after 4 months delay control group, with no changes in the anti-epileptic drugs. The seizure frequency after 4 months was significantly lower in the 54 children in the diet group, 38% decrease in seizures, compared to the 49 controls. They had a 37% increase in seizures. And are there any long-term studies? There was a study that followed 216 ketogenic diet patients for around 20 years. Some people dropped out, and only 140 of the initial patients, which is 65%, remained on the diet until the end of the study. 20.5% of patients became seizure-free. 36% had a 75 to 99% decrease in seizures. 56.5% of the patients had a seizure control of more than 75%. There were improvements in all types of epilepsy. And some patients who discontinued the ketogenic diet and started eating carbs again had reoccurrence of seizures. It is recommended to follow a ketogenic diet long term. So, what are my tips to make the ketogenic diet more sustainable for epileptic patients? First, this diet is not about weighing foods and tracking every bite of food. The goal of this diet is to reach the state of ketosis. And you can achieve it by reducing your daily carbohydrate intake to no more than 50 grams of carbohydrates a day. And the carbohydrates that you eat can be a little bit of honey, high sugar fruits, oats or rice. Your carbohydrate sources have to be healthy, non-starchy foods such as broccoli, cabbage, Brussels sprouts, kale, spinach, zucchini, aubergine, tomatoes, peppers, green beans and similar non-starchy vegetables. Also, if you're an adult who has epilepsy, having bulletproof keto coffees is a good idea because it's an easy way to add some butter and coconut oil into your coffee. And you should also have only healthy fat sources, no margarine, no vegetable oils, only healthy sources such as organic full-fat meat, full-fat dairy, organic eggs, wild fatty fish such as sardines, salmon and anchovies, nuts, seeds, olives, extra virgin olive oil, coconut oil, and avocados. And if you observe that any of these foods make you feel unwell, they make you bloated or inflamed, try out different ones. There's an endless list of healthy low-carb keto foods that you can eat. And to improve your results even further, you should also try intermittent fasting. It promotes healing and has similar health benefits to those of ketosis. Using these two methods in combination is what gives the best results. And if you or your child have epilepsy and you need help and support for starting a low-carb, high-fat ketogenic diet, feel free to contact me by email. I coach people online and I create personalized meal plans. And if you found this video useful, don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And you can also support my YouTube channel by buying me a coffee or signing up for my Patreon. And if you know anyone who would benefit from watching this video, feel free to share it with them. And share your personal experiences with keto and epilepsy in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.